Good morning, Manny Young, and welcome back to another episode of Manny Young Morning.
This episode is all about padel.
Yes, it's a brand new sport that's made its way right here to Manny Young.
First up, we have Scott and Marcos, the founders of Padelphia, joining us on the couch to talk about the sport.
Yep, and then Meg will be heading down to check out the new facilities on this episode's store tour.
And then Marcos is going to show me how to play the sport on this week's Dillinger Does It. But first up, the Manny Young Morning Minute.
DJ Murder from Main Street Music will be spinning for a musical pleasure at Lucky's Last Chance on July 22nd from 10 p.m. to midnight. Cook, drink, and socialize while you cook a delicious meal from start to finish at Northlake Community Center on July 24th. American Idol alumni Crystal Bowersox is coming to the Locks at Sona on July 25th. Bring your French Bulldog to the Pet Friendly Dog Bakery on July 27th for a special play date just for them. Head to La Roca on July 29th from 7 to 8:30 p.m. for an exciting evening filled with succulents, cacti, tequila, and creativity. It's Fitness Night at Stroll the Street on August 1st, and Philadelphia Runner is teaming up with Orange Theory and Brooks for a fun Fit Night in Manayunk.
On August 1st from 6 to 8 p.m., attendees will have a chance to check out Salt Design Studio. Hidden River Yarns is hosting a trunk show with Shirsty Cat on August 2nd from 4 to 8 p.m. City Bird is a small group travel company for young professionals, making every city in the world feel like a city you have a friend in. Head to Sona Pub and Kitchen on August 9th from 7 to 9 p.m. for a fun night of great conversations with singles in their 30s and 40s. You won't want to miss Cover Band Night at the Grape Room on August 9th from 7:30 p.m. to 1:30 a.m.
Lots to do in Manayunk as usual, and now joining us on the couch, Scott and Marcos from Padelphia.
Guys, come on down.
Hey, Leo,
hey
good to see you. Thank you.
Glad to have you
Thank
on the couch.
You.
Good.
All right.
So much energy here.
Yeah,
I love
absolutely.
It. It's great. We're ready to talk about this.
Absolutely.
I know, right? It's like they're coming out for the big game here today.
We are the team. From Padelphia, part of the team.
We have our game face on today.
Love it. So guys, the very first question we have to ask is, what is padel? Tell us the whole background on this sport.
So padel is... It is going to be the most trendy sport in the U.S. from now on. It is like a kind of mix between tennis, racquetball, squash. If you take all the beautiful things for all these racquet sports, probably what came up is padel.
It's played on a court similar to a tennis court, but it's about a third the size. It still has a net in the middle. It's played on turf, and then that court is surrounded with glass. So everything's in play. The ball never really stops moving until you hit it in the net.
Yeah, going everywhere. Right?
It's all you got to keep your eye on it.
So what would you say separates it from those other racket sports? Is it the fact that everything's in play, or?
The learning process, that is a key thing, because you know, in 10 minutes, everyone can get introduced to the sport. As soon as you get into the court for, let's say 5 minutes, you can be successful, you can bring all your friends and have a lot of fun with them, so.
I think one of the things you see in the other racket sports like tennis and squash is they're a little intimidating. To go on the sport, if you've never played it before, there's a big learning curve that needs to happen before you can really enjoy the sport and play it the way it's meant to be played. That doesn't exist in padel. You can play at a level where you can actually enjoy the sport. We're here because this is an area that is thriving with fitness places. You can row, you can box. You can yoga, you can CrossFit. All those things are here, and that's why we're here, because all those people that do those sports can complement those with playing.
So tell us about the game. Is it one-on-one? Is it two-on-two? Like, how does the process work? How do you score? You know, what do you get up to? Tell us the actual game.
It's really very relatively easy to learn because the scoring is the exact same way as tennis. And then from there, the game is traditionally and most always played in doubles, and that's one of the reasons it's so social. But from there, padel kind of becomes unique in that the game is a little slower moving, but placement of the ball means so much. So we like to say if tennis is checkers, padel is chess.
What would you guys say is one of the greatest challenges of the game?
It's getting good. It's the addictive taste of you'll get out there and you'll play the first time and you'll play at a level that you can enjoy playing, but you want to get better. The hard part of padel is putting the racket down and walking away from the court.
So you guys are down on Venice Island. If someone wants to come down and play, what do they have to do? They have to sign up, or they just got to find you guys? Or
if you're in the area, you're a member of our club. All you need to do is come down. You can go online at Padelphia and reserve a court, or just stop down. Our hours are from 5 to 9 weeknights, 8 to 1 on Saturdays. We also have a bunch of events for people to learn to play. So we have clinics on Thursday nights, Saturday mornings, and we also have an open play where people can just show up. $10, we'll give you a racket, balls, and there'll be people to play with you, walk on the court, and experience the game.
Well, thanks again for joining us today, guys, and teaching us more about padel.
Always a pleasure.
Absolutely, thank you very much.
And now Megan's gonna go check out the padel courts on this week's store tour.
Thanks, Leo. I'm down here at Padelphia with Scott from All Racket Sports USA for this week's store tour. Scott, thanks so much for having us today.
Thank you so much for coming out and experiencing Padel.
What is Padel and how did it get here?
Padel is a racket sport that we are bringing to the United States. It's unique in that it combines elements of all racket sports like squash, tennis, racquetball. We like to call it the Swiss Army knife of racquet sports because I think it combines the most fun elements of all those games into one small package that's easy to learn how to play, but yet very difficult to master.
Can you tell us when you started this? What was that process like?
So we spent the last 2 years traveling all over the United States, putting on exhibitions, and we wanted to find a home where we could actually set up a court or two for an extended period of time rather than just a quick exhibition. We found that here in Manayunk with the help of the Philadelphia Parks and Rec Commission, who were so generous to let us use this area, and the help of the Manayunk Development Corporation, particularly Jane, in saying, hey, Venice Island is the perfect place in the whole United States to put this.
And you have a great little pro shop there too. So what can we find in there?
Well, you got to find all the things you need to play the sport. You need, first of all, you need rackets and balls, and you can find them in there. We have rackets that we loan to people to play if it's your first time playing or just getting used to. Also vital to a pro shop is a pro. And you'll usually find our pro Marco sitting in there, and he's the one that's going to get you on the court, sign you up with some court time, give you a lesson or whatever you need to get adept at playing.
And I see you have some benches for people who want to watch too.
Padel is a very intimate sport. So unlike tennis, if I'm watching you play tennis, you're probably on the court. I'm hanging out over the on the other side of a chain link fence. For Padel, if I'm watching you play, I can stand right up beside of the court. I can easily carry on a conversation with you and the other players on the court without shouting or yelling. So it becomes very intimate. It's very fun, kind of like what pickleball is here. Everybody's having fun.
So they're here until the fall.
Yes.
But when can people come and play?
And we are open from 5 to 9 on weekday evenings. And then we are also open on Saturday mornings from 8 to 1, and then again from 5 to 9. You can also go to padelphia.com and reserve a court. You also want to go there to see, we offer special clinics on Thursday nights and Saturday mornings that are designed to teach beginner, intermediate, and advanced people how to play the game. And one of the most fun things we have is on Wednesday night, we have open play. So for $10, you come out, you get a racket, you stay all night, you don't need to bring friends, there'll be here people to play, and we get you on the court. We just have a big social rotation of people on and off the court, everybody having fun, learning to play padel, and it's for all different skill levels.
So why did you want to open in Manayunk? And more importantly, what do you love about being at Manayunk?
This is an active lifestyle community. This is an active lifestyle game. It's the perfect fit. I can't think of a better place than in Manayunk.
Well, Scott, it's been so great learning more about padel, and thank you so much for giving us a tour today.
Thank you for coming out. I love talking about padel, but even more, I love playing padel. So this is a real easy topic for me. Thank you.
And now we're going to send it back to the couch.
That was a great store tour, Meg. I really can't wait to learn how to play some padel.
Yeah, aren't you supposed to be down there already, Leo? Are you late again?
No, I just got to do something totally unrelated. Hey guys, welcome to a brand new segment of Dillinger Does It. I'm here with Marcos from Padelphia. Marcos.
Hello, how are you, man?
Welcome to the show.
Thank you, Leo.
All right. So Marcos, what are we going to be learning today?
I think what we can start being, you know, going through the very, very basic fundamentals for understanding the game.
Okay.
So we can start doing the very basic things, which is getting familiar with the probably the defensive area, you know, hitting the ball in front of you, probably hitting after the wall, which is forehand and backhand off the wall, and then sending a lob and coming to the net for hitting a couple of volleys and a good smash. You'll love it.
All right, let's do it.
Let's go, come on.
All right, so what's the first step?
What I want you to make sure is that you understand this is what we call the defensive area. So every time that you feel close to the wall, so when you are receiving the ball in front of you, what I want you to do is like you do in tennis. So try to do one step forward all the time, early preparation,
yep.
And then try to adjust a little bit for hitting it like you do in tennis. So if the ball is coming to you for your backhand, one step forward, getting ready, early preparation again, stepping forward, and then after adjusting, hit it this way. Now, what I want you to understand is the lob here in padel is probably the most important stroke. Start here, you know, and what I want you to do now is by doing this, you gotta put all your attention on letting the ball go to the wall, exactly, and now you are gonna use your legs as an elevator. So the ball will be doing this, And when it's here, I want you to use your legs as an elevator for sending the ball that way. Drive the ball. You know, you gotta travel with it instead of hit it.
A little bit more control.
Exactly. Yeah. So at the moment you send the lob, we'll be here, exactly here, for making the offensive things, okay. Right? By finding here, what I want you to do is first thing, try to face with the face of the racket to the ball this way, putting all your weight this way, and then step forward, looking for the impact to the ball. When the ball is coming on your left side, it's gonna be exactly the same. It's starting here, which is the starting position, and now try to show the shoulder to the ball and the face of the racket again without making any step, and now is the moment for stepping forward. What you gotta be looking for is for the easy ball that you are trying to finish, and that ball will be used by hitting a smash that you are probably familiar with.
Yep. I love the smash. Yep.
You gotta hit it like crazy and push the pedal to the metal.
Pedal to the metal. All right, let's do it. Marcos.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Very well done, man. Good job.
So would you say that Dillinger did it?
Dillinger did it.
All right.
Well done, man.
Guys, be sure to come check out Padel right here in Manayunk on Venice Island.
Visit us here in Padelphia to experience the sport of Padel, the new trendy sport coming to the U.S.
And we'll see you next time on Dillinger Does It.
Bye-bye. See ya.
Well, that's our show for today. Thanks again for joining us for another episode of Manayunk Morning. Special thanks, as always, to Terry Leahy Films for producing this episode, and The Isle for hosting us here on the couch, and all of our show sponsors. As always, I'm Caitlin.
I'm Leo.
And these are the guys from Padelphia, and we'll see you next time on Manayunk Mornings.
Bye-bye. Bye.